Good morning and welcome to St John's with St Mary's in Isleworth. This is our online service. My name is David. I'm one of the ministers here in the church. Today is the 14th of November, which is also Remembrance Sunday. And I know many of you will be marking it in different ways, either in church with us or down at the memorial or both. But here we're just going to have a few thoughts about remembrance for our online service today. We will actually begin with a hymn. O God, our help in ages past. And just at the start of our service, let's say this is the collect prayer, a short prayer as we consider Remembrance Sunday. Ever living God, we remember those whom you've gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lizzie is going to bring us our reading.
Psalm 16. Preserve me, O God, for in you I have taken refuge. I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, all my good depends on you. All my delight is upon the godly that are in the land, upon those who are noble in heart. Though the idols are legion that many run after, their drink offerings of blood I will not offer, neither make mention of their names upon my lips. The Lord himself is my portion and my cup. In your hands alone is my fortune. My share has fallen in a fair land. Indeed, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel, and in the night watches he instructs my heart. I have set the Lord always before me. He is at my right hand. I shall not fall. Wherefore my heart is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My flesh shall also rest secure. For you will not abandon my soul to death, nor suffer your faithful one to see the pit. You will show me the path of life. In your presence is the fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you to Lizzie. Now, we've just had Psalm 16 read. Psalm 16, I expect, has been a comfort for many people, an ancient hymn written by King David some 3,000 years ago. And I was thinking about this period of life that we're in as we're coming out of the pandemic, and many people have said that the last 18 months have felt a bit like a wartime mentality. In one sense, you think that can't be right. That's not quite right. The trauma of war, the threat of violence and the possibility of having to flee your home, the instant and dramatic destruction of the things you love, and a human enemy, these are the things that wartime generations faced in this country, and people in parts of the world also still live through times like these. But the pandemic, it hasn't quite been the same as that. It's a different type of crisis, and I guess we need to honour and remember those who particularly have died in war, while we recognise there are some similarities with this time that we're in, of a crisis, of a pandemic. Some of the similarities between a kind of wartime and between life in the pandemic. We found that we've been separated from loved ones, and we worry for the well-being of loved ones we can't be with. There's lots of talk of death and counting casualties. There's the grief and not being able to grieve well if we've been separated from loved ones. There are heroes at this time, as there are in war times. The NHS for us, those who support the efforts to combat the spread of the virus. And there is an enemy. It's an unseen airborne virus. But as a result, people have been very nervous of each other, and we keep our distance. It's a different kind of enemy than maybe during the wars, but still an enemy nonetheless. We've had some shortages of supplies in the supermarkets. I mean, we don't have rationing, but there's been at least a disruption to our way of life that has impacted jobs and income, the education of our children and young people, and all of our plans to one degree or another. And in some other ways, the pandemic is a unique disaster for us, which makes it different to war, maybe even worse in some respects. An older person said to me, in the war, at least we had each other. We could chat and touch and sing, but we can't even do that now. Speaking about our life in the lockdown before. Now, this is a psalm, Psalm 16, that I imagine people have said and used as a prayer during a time of war, and maybe during this time of the pandemic. The psalms give us the words to say back to God. They help us with when we run out of words or we're not quite sure how to pray, they give us the words to say. They are some of the most helpful parts of the Bible, these ancient prayers, and they're as relevant now as they were when they were written. Whatever our age, whatever we're going through, I hope Psalm 16 can help. We look to God for help. Three things that we learn very quickly. We learn that God is a refuge. This is how it starts. Protect me, O God, for in you I take refuge, the psalmist says. A place of protection. We have a cat, which is a bit of a scaredy cat, nervous creature. She's quite old. And when Ollie visits with his dog, or when another animal is in the house, she just runs upstairs and hides, finds a room, a quiet spot where she can be safe. And we don't tend to let the dogs upstairs. Knowing God gives us somewhere to hide, somewhere to run to. It's the upstairs for the cat. It's a place for us to speak our worries. Our worries don't just need to churn internally. We have an outward expression for them. It's where we take our concerns. It's the hands that we place ourselves in. It's where our anxieties can go. God gives us reassurance that we're not alone, that we're held safe in his arms, that whatever happens, he sees us. and gives us a place of shelter. Peace and joy are the result. It's not just protection. We actually experience peace and joy. Even in the midst of hardship, sometimes on the hardest days, we can know God's peace in a deep and profound way. That's been true in my life. So God is a refuge, a place of protection. We also learn that God counsels us in the night. Here's a verse that was in the psalm. I bless the Lord who gives me counsel in the night. Also my heart instructs me. I think that one of the things I like about the Psalms is that the psalmists are very honest. They're very real humans. And many of them seem to have trouble with sleeping. I sometimes have trouble with sleeping. And I think that when we're nervous or anxious, or many people find that they don't sleep well, and they're tossing and turning in the night, and they're thinking. And this psalm says that God counsels us in the night. That's actually, I've come to see, an invitation for us to speak to God. There's nothing else going on. We can't really do anything. Oh, you can try and get up and get on with things. But anyway, I think that the best thing in some ways is to just try and accept, I'm not asleep. I thought I would be. The house is asleep. I don't want to wake anyone up. Maybe there's an invitation to pray and commit myself and the things that I'm worried about into God's hands. And I found again and again, not only do I receive peace, sometimes things click into place and I have counsel. I have wisdom. The teachings of the Bible, the wisdom of other Christian people in my life can start to fall into place. And I find I have perspective. God counsels us in the night. So God is a refuge. God counsels us in the night. Maybe there's an invitation to pray when you're awake at night. And God rescues us from death is the final thing I was going to add. And we read in the psalm, you do not give me up to Sheol. That's almost like a word for hell or death. And or let your faithful one see the pit. You show me the path of life. So even in the place of death, there can be life for those that trust in God. We see this in Jesus, who faced death for us, who died that we might live and rises to new life. His death, which looked like the most ugly and heartbreaking thing in the world, actually became the access to life for all of us. Nothing can separate us from God's love. Not even death is what we learn. God rescues us from death. So it means that whatever happens, even in the worst of circumstances, we are held by God, even through death. And I think that that would have been a huge encouragement to many soldiers. Many soldiers who fought would have had small pocket Bibles with them. And I imagine many of them might have read a psalm like this, that actually in the trenches or in the Spitfires or in whichever part of the apparatus of war they were in, even death could not separate them from God and they would know life with God. Remembrance Day allows us to give thanks for the sacrifices of others, to give us these others who've given us so much in the peace that we enjoy today. It's good that we should do that. For Christians, however, every day or every Sunday is Remembrance Day because we come to communion, which many of us will celebrate in our buildings. And it's there that we remember that Jesus brought us life by his bread, by his body and his blood, symbolized by the bread and the wine. And we say we do this in remembrance of him. His death brings us life, and we therefore need not fear. So place yourself in God's hands, trust in God, keep that dialogue going where you're worried and anxious inside, directed upwards. Receive the peace of God, receive the counsel at night, and remember that you are held so firmly that not even death can separate you from God's love. I'm just going to pray a short prayer set for Remembrance Sunday. Father of all, remember your holy promise and look with love on all your people, living and departed. On this day, we especially ask that you would hold forever all who have suffered during war, those who returned scarred by warfare, those who waited anxiously at home, and those who returned wounded and disillusioned, those who mourned, and those communities that were diminished and suffered loss. Remember too those who acted with kindly compassion, those who bravely risked their own lives for their comrades, and those who in the aftermath of war worked tirelessly for a more just and peaceful world. And as you remember them, remember us, O Lord. Grant us peace in our time and a longing for the day when people of every language, race and nation will be brought into the unity of Christ's kingdom. We all ask all this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So I think we will end there for today, our online service, but I hope to see you soon. Hope you're all well. God be with you and God bless you.